Hi everyone, in this video we will learn about exception handling in Kotlin. Now the first question here is, what is an exception? Exception is an abnormal condition, means your code is successfully compiled and you can execute it. But while executing the code, any event that interrupts the normal flow of your code execution is called exception. Or in very simpler word, we can say that any error that occurs in runtime is called an exception. Some exceptions are arithmetic exception, null pointer exception, index out of bound exception, IO exception, etc. Now these all are classes, and we use these classes to handle exceptions. If required, you can also create your own custom exception class. So any exception class contains three things. The first one is the message that defines the error, then stack trace, and we have an optional cause. Now let's see how we can handle exception in our code. But before that, let's raise an exception. Now for example, I will write two variables here. First one is val a, let's say the value is 10, and I have val b, that is 0. Now if I will try to divide a with b, then I will get an arithmetic exception, that is divide by 0 exception. So what I will do is I will write println and I will write here a divided by b, and let's see what happens. Now if I run the code, you can see our code crashed and I am getting an arithmetic exception, that is divide by 0. Now the same way, if I have a list, let's say I have a list of names and let's say I have only one name inside this list. Now if I will try to access names 1 that is not available inside this list, I will get an exception that is called index out of bound exception. So these are exceptions and we need to handle the exceptions in our code. So to handle the exception, what we can do is we can use try and catch block. So the syntax is, we write try like this and we write catch, and inside the parenthesis after the catch keyword we define a class, the exception class that we want to catch. For example, let's say this time I want to catch arithmetic exception like this. So here I can put the code that will generate an exception. Let's say I will write here println 2 divided by 0, and inside catch block I will print e dot message. Now what will happen is our code will not crash, and this time we are getting a message that is divide by 0. So what happens is, you create a try block and inside try block you put the code that may raise an exception. Now if any exception is raised inside the try block, the execution of the try block will stop from that line and you will immediately go inside catch block. So here basically we are catching the exception. Now the code will not crash, but the execution will stop. For example, here the exception raised. Now if I have other lines here, let's say hello and hello one, now these two lines will not be executed, but we will come directly inside the catch block. And here we can handle the exception case inside the catch block. Now if I run the code, you can see we are inside catch block, we are getting the message that is divide by 0, and these two lines are not executing because the exception is raised at this line. Now if I put the exception at the next line, now this time you will see hello, because the exception will be raised at this line in this situation. You can see we are getting a hello, then inside catch block and the message. Now remember, whenever you are using try block, you have to use a catch block. So I hope you got the point how you can handle an exception. Now there is one more keyword, that is finally. Now if you are using finally, catch block is optional. So either you have to use a catch block or a finally block. Now catch block will only execute when an exception is raised. If no exception happened in your code, then catch block will not be executed. But finally block will be called irrespective of exception happened or not happened. So what we do is we put some critical code inside try block that may raise an exception. Inside the catch block, we handle the exception case. And inside finally block, we put some important code that we have to execute whether we had an exception or not. Now you can also use try and catch as expressions. For example, we have two vals, a equals to 10 and val b equals to 0. Now we can get the result in another val and we can write try a divided by b. Now it will return the result, but if there is an exception, we have to handle it inside the catch block. So we have again arithmetic exception and here we can return 0. Now we can print the result and we will get the result or 0 because we are handling the exception using try and catch. You can see we are getting 0. Now if I will change the value of b to 2, I will get the actual result. You can see here. Now if you have to write multiple lines inside try and catch, inside try block, then the last statement is the return value. And same applies for catch block. You can see we are inside try block, the result is 5. Now if I make the b to 0, we will go inside the catch block and the result is 0. So first we went inside the try block, this line is okay, but at this line we got an exception. So we went inside the catch block and we print inside catch block and we get the return value, that is 0, and we are printing 0 from this line. So this is how you can use try, catch and finally to handle your exceptions. Now you can also throw exceptions if required. So let's say I have a function vote and to this function I will pass, let's say, name of the voter and age of the voter. Now if age is less than 18, in this case we can throw an exception, and this time I will throw illegal argument exception and I will give the message as younger than 18 cannot vote. Now in the else case I can write voted, just for example. So to throw an exception, we use this throw keyword and then we create an instance of our exception class. Now you can use any class here, and if you want you can also create your own exception class. So very first we have the throwable class. So I will tell you the class hierarchy. First we have throwable class, then we have exception class, and then we have all other exceptions that are predefined. Now you can also create your own exception class. For example, I can create a class that is illegal voter exception, or you can give your class any name. And I can extend the exception class here. I can pass a message to my class like this, and I can pass the same message to my exception super class, And here I can use this class if required, like this. So right now I am throwing my custom exception here. Now if I call this function, let's say I will call it here. I'm calling vote, I will pass my name and let's say my age is 17. Now if I will run the code, you can see I am getting the illegal voter exception and I am getting the message. Now I can handle this exception using try and catch like this, and I can pass illegal voter exception. Now sometimes if you are not sure which class to write here, you can simply write exception. And here I can print the stack trace using a predefined function, that is print stack trace. Now this time I will get the same thing, but this time our code is not crashing. As you can see, we are getting the other results as well. So that is why we need to handle the exception. Now one more thing, you can have multiple catch blocks. For example, you are catching multiple exceptions. For example, you have 2-3 exceptions that may happen inside the try block. Then in that case, you can have multiple catch blocks like this. But you can have only a single finally block. So that's it for exception handling, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something, and you learned how you can handle exceptions in Kotlin. In case you have any confusion or questions, you can leave your comments below. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Belal Khan now signing off.